Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com. At a presser yesterday introducing Jalen Hood-Schifino and Max Lewis, Lakers GM Rob Pelinka explained that he expects to bring back much of the young core of the team. Now, that it would include Austin Reeves, Rui Hachimura, D'Angelo Russell is apparently part of that group as well that the Lakers will intend to keep this year during free agency. But those aren't the only names that they're going to look to hang on to. According to Yovan Buha of The Athletic, the Lakers will also try to retain Dennis Schroder and Lonnie Walker. Now, Lonnie Walker, of course, had that incredible Game 3 in the Western Conference semifinals against the Golden State Warriors, exploding in the fourth quarter. He had found himself out of the rotation for a good chunk of the season, but at 6'4", with insane athleticism and just 24 years old, Lonnie Walker could be a fit long-term for the Lakers at the guard position. The Lakers can give him a little bit under $8 million starting based on his contract that he got last year with the team, unless they want to get into one of their exceptions. Speaking of which, the Lakers have a decision to make, two of them actually. Tomorrow is the deadline to decide on Mo Bamba's non-guaranteed deal that would pay him $10.3 million. Do the Lakers want to guarantee that number or not? And Malik Beasley has a team option at $16.5 million. Do the Lakers want to pick up that option for next year or not? Again, they have until tomorrow to make their decision there. They could potentially pick up those options and trade those players, or they could decide to waive both players and clear that money off their books. They could try to re-sign them. A lot of different options for the Lakers, and we'll have a little bit more insight onto what they're doing when that deadline hits tomorrow. Now, the reason why I bring that up in relation to Lonnie Walker is if the Lakers need to use this mid-level exception to hang on to Lonnie Walker or even perhaps Dennis Schroder, what they do with Bamba and Beasley will likely determine whether or not they have access to that full mid-level exception of $12.4 million or if they only have the taxpayer mid-level exception of $5 million. Picking up the options on both Beasley and Bamba would likely steer them towards the smaller taxpayer mid-level, again, at just $5 million. There is another path where the Lakers could potentially clear cap space and actually be a cap space team, but it doesn't seem likely that that's the road that they are going to go down. Now, Dennis Schroder is another player the Lakers would like to retain, which makes a lot of sense. Clearly, he's a favorite of head coach Darvin Ham's. He's somebody who the Lakers counted on quite a bit defensively at the guard position and did a lot for the Lakers in the fourth quarter over the course of the season. Had a number of big games where he came up big in the clutch, either getting himself to the free throw line, getting defensive stops or a steal, or hitting a big bucket. Dennis Schroder was instrumental for the Lakers and was an incredible value on a veteran minimum contract, but how much will they be willing to pay in order to keep Schroder, who turns 30 before the start of next season? And again, the Lakers did just draft Jalen Hood-Schifino, another point guard, with the 17th pick in the NBA draft. But nonetheless, sounds like the Lakers are backing up their words. Rob Pelinka said, we want to bring back the core of this team. We're already hearing that they want to bring back Austin Reeves, Rui Hachimura, both those players restricted. I would be surprised if either one of them found themselves playing elsewhere next season. D'Angelo Russell is a free agent, but I think it makes sense for both parties, both D'Lo and the Lakers, for him to come back. The only question is, what does that deal look like? But now we're also hearing, according to Yovan Buha of The Athletic, that they want to retain both Dennis Schroder and Lonnie Walker. We'll see what it takes contract-wise to get that done and if that's something the Lakers can do, as well as what the opportunity cost to signing those players may be in terms of other moves the Lakers can make when free agency does kick off 6 o'clock Eastern time on Friday. Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. Should the Lakers retain Lonnie Walker, retain Dennis Schroder, and what should they do with their options on Malik Beasley and Mo Bamba? Again, let me know in the comments section. Till next time, everybody. See ya. And stay safe.